dragon's breath is an actual dragon?
Tetha! Bars!
Inquisition! Nira Atasi Asara! Mirabas Adim Kata! Hisrad, we need you! Videk Kathas!
Good call leaving me behind. The Vidasala asked me to lend a hand. Nothing personal. Bas.
Canary and see where it gets you.
He was honest with you from the start. I'll give him that much.
This whole time? Just friggin' Lopon, son of a pissing shit.
Bishanta Kapas.
I still don't understand how he could fight beside us for years and just. Oh, come on. Let's move.
dangerous. We can't let the Canary keep it.
They fought so much. Life. Or something
after. That's not. Oh, have they ruined fighting a dragon?
Too dangerous. We can't let the Canary keep it.
They called so much life or something after. That's not. Oh, have they ruined fighting a dragon?
Thank you. is too dangerous. We can't let the Canary keep it.
They hold so much. I or something out of her. That's not... Ugh, how'd they ruin fighting a dragon?
Thank you.
monster is too dangerous. We can't let the Canary keep it.
They've pulled so much life or something out of her. That's not... Oh, how they ruin fighting a dragon.
Inquisitor, you have such little time left. You must finally see the truth. Elven magic already tore the sky apart. If the agents of Fen'Harel are not stopped, you will shatter the world as well.
The Inquisition has nothing to do with these agents.
Come, Inquisitor. I am the eyes and ears of the Canary people. Do you think you can deceive me?
You would have died from the mark on your hand, but for the help of one of their chief agents. The same agent who helped seal the breach, who led you to Skyhold, who gave Corypheus the orb, then founded the Inquisition. Solas, agent of Fen'Harel.
That's stupid. It is, right? I mean, wait. Oh, piss.
Solas wanted that orb. If the agents of Fen'Harel gave it to Corypheus, he couldn't be one.
Or perhaps he was tasked with removing the evidence of his group's interference. Solas tricked us all. He pushed a dying Canary into the Winter Palace to lure you into opposing us. Without him, we could have brought the South peace and wisdom along the gentle path. Now we must take the way of blades. Hannah Hayden, Inquisitor. If it is any consolation, Solas will not outlive you.
Solas, come on!
The Vidasala can't be far. That can't be healthy. Perhaps Solas can help.
Hated is too smart for you, Pity, before the whole agent of Fenny business. He better help. We're owed.
Be where Solas is.
Ah!
That must be where Solus is.
Their leader woman.
Zerabas, Rathral, Shokra!
Mage. He's always with their leader woman.
Thank you.
comes. Let's have you.
Time to finish this.
You are... Red Inquisitor, your soul is dust!
Thank you.
above.
To finish this.
You are dead, Inquisitor. Your soul is dust.
Thank you. Ebesit kata, etwa ost.
Maras kata!
Your forces have failed. Leave now and tell the Canari to trouble me no further.
Solas.
Should give us more time. I suspect you have questions.
The Kunari believe you're an agent for someone who has taken the name Fen'Harel.
The Kunari reject myth and legend. If you told them of your meeting with Mithal, they would attribute it to a demon. I am no one's agent but my own. I fear that the truth is much simpler and much worse than the Canari believe.
You're Fen'Harel.
I was Solas first. Fen'Harel came later. An insult I took as a badge of pride. The Dread Wolf inspired hope in my friends and fear in my enemies. Not unlike Inquisitor, I suppose. You also know the burden of a title that all but replaces your name.
Our legends about you are wrong. I saw the truth as we traveled the crossroads.
You saw another story, written in desperation to give me more credit than I ever deserved.
You were a hero, Solas.
I sought to set my people free from slavery to would-be gods. I broke the chains of all who wished to join me. The false gods called me Fen'Harel, and when they finally went too far, I formed the veil and banished them forever. Thus I freed the Elven people, and in so doing, destroyed their world.
You said that the Elven gods went too far. What did they do that made you move against them?
They killed Mithal. Crime for which an eternity of torment is the only fitting punishment.
I thought Mithal was one of the Evanuris.
She was the best of them. She cared for her people. She protected them. She was a voice of reason. And in their lust for power, they killed her.
You banished the false gods. You didn't kill them.
You met Mithal, did you not? The first of my people do not die so easily. The Evanuris are banished forever, paying the ultimate price for their misdeeds.
You love the Fade. Why would you create the veil to hide it all away?
Because every alternative was worse.
Meaning?
Had I not created the veil, the Evanuris would have destroyed the entire world.
How did creating the veil destroy the world?
You saw the remains of Vyadithara. The library was intrinsically tied to the Fade, and the veil destroyed it. There were countless other marvels, all dependent on the presence of the Fade, all destroyed. Your legends are half right. We were immortal. It was not the arrival of humans that caused us to begin aging. It was me. The veil took everything from the elves. Even themselves.
The Evanuris were elven mages. How did they come to be remembered as gods?
Slowly. It started with a war. War breeds fear. Fear breeds a desire for simplicity. Good and evil, right and wrong, chains of command. After the war ended, generals became respected elders, and kings, finally gods. The Avenuris.
That's the past. What about the future?
I lay in dark and dreaming sleep while countless wars and ages passed. I woke still weak a year before I joined you. My people fell for what I did to strike the Avenuris down. But still, some hope remains for restoration. I will save the Elven people, even if it means this world must die.
Why does this world have to die for the Elves to return?
A good question, but not one I will answer. You will survive this day, Inquisitor. And though I owed you an explanation, I will not give you tools to use against me. I am not Corypheus. I take no joy in this. But the return of my people means the end of yours. It is my fight. You should be more concerned about the Inquisition, your Inquisition. In stopping the Dragon's Breath, you have prevented an invasion by Qunari forces. With luck, they will return their focus to Devinta. That should give you a few years of relative peace.
The Qunari said the Inquisition was unknowingly working for agents of Fen'Harel.
I gave no orders.
You led us to Skyhold.
Corypheus should have died unlocking my orb. When he survived, my plans were thrown into chaos. When you survived, I saw the Inquisition as the best hope this world had of stopping him. And you needed a home. Hence, Skyhold.
You gave your orb to Corypheus?
Not directly. My agents allowed the Venatori to locate it. The orb had built up magical energy while I lay unconscious for millennia. I was not powerful enough to open it. The plan was for Corypheus to unlock it, and for the resulting explosion to kill him. Then I would claim the orb. I did not foresee a Devinta Magister having learned the secret of effective immortality.
What would have happened if Corypheus had died? And you'd recovered the orb.
I would have entered the Fade using the mark you now bear. Then I would have torn down the veil. As this world burned in the raw chaos, I would have restored the world of my time. The world of the Elves.
If you destroyed the veil, wouldn't the false gods be freed?
I had plans.
So, at least some of the stories about the Dreadwolf are true.
I did not lead a rebellion against immortal mage kings without getting my hands bloody. You must understand. I awoke in a world where the veil had blocked most people's conscious connection to the Fade. It was like walking through a world of tranquil.
We aren't even people to you.
The fault is hardly yours. The veil was my creation, another of my countless mistakes.
Whatever your reasons, we couldn't have defeated Corypheus without you.
Do not thank me. Without my orb, Corypheus would never have been such a threat.
You control the Illuvians now?
Yes. You remember Briala from Halam Shiral? For a time, she controlled part of the labyrinth. One of my agents was supposed to take it from her, but he did not succeed. I had to override the magic personally. The Qunari stumbled upon this section independently. With them gone, the Illuvians are now mine.
What's wrong with the Inquisition?
You created a powerful organization, and now it suffers the inevitable fate of such. Betrayal and corruption.
It's not that simple.
Isn't it? Perhaps we should ask your friend, the Iron Bull. Tell me, where is he? Do you know how I discovered the Canary plot? The plot I disrupted by leading them to your doorstep. The Canary spies in the Inquisition tripped over my spies in the Inquisition. The Elven Guard who led you to the Canary bot, who intercepted the servant with the Gatlock barrel? Mine.
Why bother disrupting the Canary plot if you're going to destroy the world regardless?
I will do what I must. But there is no benefit in allowing harm to come to innocence before it's necessary. And the Canary offended me.
So you let us do your dirty work?
The mistake was yours to fix, Inquisitor.
There's still the matter of the anchor. It's getting worse.
Yes. Ultimately, none but I could have borne the mark and lived. Your death would cause more senseless chaos, more bloodshed. It is unnecessary. Though I doubt you will thank me. Live well, while time remains.
Something must be done, but we cannot lose the Inquisition now. We stand on the brink of war with the Canary.
Yes, because this Solas provoked them in the first place.
The Inquisition did not cause this threat. We informed the summit of the danger.
The danger posed by Canary spies inside your organization.
Without our organization, I doubt you would be alive to complain.
No one has forgotten what you have done. But Corypheus is 2 years dead.
If the Inquisition is to continue, it must do so as a legitimate organization, not a glorified mercenary band.
Inquisitor.
You all know what this is? A writ from Divine Justinia authorizing the formation of the Inquisition. We pledge to close the breach, find those responsible, and restore order, with or without anyone's approval. You're right, Altegan, we are dangerous. We've been deceived and we've made mistakes. You're right as well, Duke Cyril. These are the growing pains of a young organization in need of guidance. But you would both have the Inquisition bow to your agenda, and that is precisely what we cannot do. The Inquisition will act as Divine Victoria's personal honor guard. Answering directly to her, we will transition from a military force into a peacekeeping organization. My own adventuring days may be done, but the Inquisition and its mission will continue.
My agents have found nothing. With the Illuvians, he could be anywhere.
Maintaining the Inquisition, even as a peacekeeping force, leaves us vulnerable to agents of the Dread Wolf.
But also gives us the strength to respond.
We will need to be careful.
Solas knows everything about us. Who we are, how we work, our strengths, and weaknesses.
Then we find people he doesn't know. We will stop Solas by any means necessary.
Is this a new book? All this shit is weird.
Oh, Varric, that is a terrible title. What are you even thinking? The sky churned like a rolling sea on a dark and stormy night. Centered on a gaping hole that led to the arse end of nowhere. A hole that spit up many things that day. Comets, demons, and a whole lot of trouble. It's about the Inquisition. The din of the tavern cut the silence like it owed the Carter money. In the middle, in her element, Red Jenny. She looked me up and down, mostly down. Not playing, weirdy, she said, gesturing with and dismissively eating a sandwich. Don't write that. Seriously, piss up a rope. Sarah made the subtext text, which suited me fine. Court Enchanter swirled into the room like a drop of beautiful poison spreading in a wine glass. She sized me up with a glance.
I'm so glad you made it, my dear, she said. I am Madame de Fer, the most terrifying person you shall ever meet.
Liliana enfolded Alphonse in an embrace as warm as a serpent's kiss.
I always knew I could count on your support.
The Count did not feel the bite of her poisoned dart until it was too late.
Even if it requires your death.
Drops of rain glistened on the Griffin medallion grasped tightly in Blackwall's hand.
The silverite wings of valor, they mean nothing.
He flung the medal to the cold and uncaring ground.
You don't know what I've done. You don't know me.
So romantic. Like a shadow that also moved like a knife, a shadow wearing a hat where dreams came to die.
It's a riddle, he whispered. A cold riddle that gnaws at your mind, but you'll feel better when it's gone.
That makes as much sense as anything Cole says. Herald above the law, ambassador.
Whose law, my lady?
Josephine's eyes glittered like angry opals.
The law destroyed by rebellion, by civil war, by poor fiscal management.
We are the law. Our mark on adamant, but the dust hadn't settled, and neither had Harding.
I can offer you a drink, if I catch your meaning.
If you caught my meaning, you'd have offered a double.
What is even happening here? Iron Bull was a great slab of muscle with horns that could hang a tapestry. One eye scanned for threats, while the other hid behind an eye patch like a Chantry sister's old sins.
Come on,
he barked, not looking back as he entered.
The dancer with the great rack comes on in five.
That is spot on, actually. Commander had the look of a Templar who had seen the worst of humanity, yet still had the time to style his hair.
This isn't just a war, he said,
his gaze steely like a dull blade.
It's the only war.
Cullen! That's Cullen! Mage wore a class of handsome sneer cultivated by a thousand years of Tevinter elitism.
The name's Dorian, he glared. D-O-R-I-A-N. Spell it right, you marble-headed lump, or it's toad time.
A toad? That's hardly credible. Spun, mage staff crackling like the city after a good man's murder.
You're crazy, the Red Templar cried in terror.
Moonlight glinted off ears like the knives you never see coming.
Better to fade out than burn away.
Ugh, Varric. don't... Oh, here it is. The Seeker clutched at my vest, her tears as desperate as they were pitiful. Varric, I was wrong about everything, she sobbed. Could you find it in your noble heart to forgive me? That dwarf, he put me in the book! Oh, I'm in the book! I am reading the shit out of this!